School football in the state of Alabama has always been regarded as the most popular sport among teenagers. The city of Montgomery is one of the most highly recognizable places for this. Schools like Carver, Lee, Jeff Davis, and Lanier have well-recognizable programs, but there's another team on the rise, the Pirates of St. Jude. The 1998 St. Jude Pirates football season was an exciting one that produced a playoff berth for the young and talented team. Led by star senior running back Reginald Fred Fowler, the Pirates' record showed their will to win. The small private school in West Montgomery created a lot of noise on the gridiron in 1998.
The Pirates got off on a rocky start after being defeated by the Eagles of Montgomery Academy. The team rebounded the next week with a shutout of Lochapoca to begin a three-game winning streak.
That runs a no-huddle offense. A lot of people had come to me and said, well, how can you run no-huddle when you have so few kids? Well, I was thinking on that is the fact that we're saving our kids an extra 10 to 15 yards per play by not going to the huddle.
The Pirates crushed Utah by playing an outstanding game with major plays from Reginald Fowler and Tabaris Beatty. Running back Reginald Fowler scored a 52-yard touchdown, giving the Pirates the lead early in the first quarter. The next week, St. Jude's stifling defense gave them a victory over Catholic High.
Respect the game, yo.
Senior Larry Manigan played both sides of the ball, contributing immensely to this winning season.
Larry played cornerback for us, and I also do double duty as an offensive guard, which is a very unique combination for almost any team. You know, you got a kid out there playing corner wearing number 63. You know, he weighed about 160 pounds, and probably was our best offensive lineman. You know, had a lot to do with our success running the football this year.
I like tackling people and getting the team hype on the other side of the ball.
The manhood issue, the student issue, is the most important issue for us at St. Jude. You know, as long as we're getting those things across and we're improving on those things, I think the football and everything will take care of itself. And it's a rewarding experience when you see them, you know, go off and do well.
Stop!
After a defeat by Otagaville, the Fighting Pirates came back with a triumphant victory of 56-0 over R.C. Hatch. During the first quarter, after a Reginald Fowler touchdown, the St. Jude Pirates got a little sneaky with an onside kick that set up this touchdown reception.
Yes, Cuban made right, and the line had opened up and the block was right.
The two outside linebackers was supposed to, you know, strain the play out, and the middle linebacker was me, supposed to hit up in the hole. So what I did was, when I hit the hole, and I saw him slipping, right? So what I did, I used my good form tackle and laid the smack down on it.
St. Jude continued their winning streak with a 23-8 victory over Talladega County Central.
That block for my other tailback, and then if I would have made that block, he would have got tackled. That was a big responsibility I had to take on my shoulder.
Statue of Liberty play is to play where the quarterback comes back and has the ball behind his back, and I come take the ball from behind his back, and we run.
It wasn't really tough because in practice I went full speed and got myself in shape, so it wasn't really hard to play both sides.
A fumble recovery by Kevin Brown was not enough as the Pirates lost a heartbreaker to Minnesota.
That was real. They signed hit. What happened was their play broke down and the quarterback began to scramble. He ran down the left side of the line of scrimmage and he was hit by Timothy Robinson and Jacquez Vickers, and they ran him back my way. And I saw the opportunity and I stepped up and I laid him out.
The Pirates entered the playoffs with one thing in mind, winning. The team trampled their first opponent from Sunshine with a 58-12 victory.
313, it was a pass. It was a play that the first person threw it to was the tight end, and the line gave the proper time for the quarterback, and I was open, he threw it to me, and I scored.
The St. Jude Pirates continued their march through the playoffs with a 28-12 victory over Otagaville that led to a third-round game against Grant. In the last game of the playoffs, the Pirates fought to the finish but fell a little short of grasping victory. They were forced to play without running back Reginald Fowler, who was injured on the first offensive play. Tim Robinson was also injured but remained in the game. After the two went down, Coach Cotton came out with an unusual formation called the Seven Diamonds.
This past season for us has been joyous at times and very bad at times. I think we got a lot of things accomplished this year. You know, we came here 3 years ago with a plan, an objective, and a goal that by third year we would be one of the best teams in the state, if not the best team in the state. And I think we came very close to reaching that point. You know, I think right at the end of the season, if not the best team, we was one of the best teams in the state in 1A football, at least in the top five, I believe. Overall, I think it's been a very good season for the kids and for the school.
It was a pretty good season, but not the best season because we didn't win the championship, but it was pretty good.
This team got a lot of love for each other. Our coaches, you know, we got six guys that are assistant coaches, and none of these guys are paid to coach at St. Jude. Matter of fact, we're the only coaching staff in the state of Alabama where nobody is being paid to coach football, and that takes a lot of love.
The Pirates ended their regular season with a record of 5 wins and 5 losses and a 2-1 record in the playoffs. With an outstanding coaching staff and an outstanding team, the Pirates are sure to return to the playoffs next season.